Everybody, welcome back to my channel Vaibhav e-learning academy. Today we are going to continue our topic decimals. This is our part 6. In my previous videos I have taught you division of a decimal number when the divisor is 10, 100, 1000 etc. or division of a decimal number when the divisor is a whole number or a divide or a decimal number. So all those videos I just taught multiplication of decimal and division of decimal. In this video, let us try something different. We are going to learn units of measurement, that is the metric system. The metric system. In this video, we shall try to find out answer of 3 questions. What is a metric system? When was the metric system used? And where do we use the metric system? The answer to the first question is, the metric system is a system of measurement that is succeeded the decimalized system based upon the meter. So, do you know what is that meter name? That meter is called the SI unit. What is an SI unit? SI unit is the standard unit of measurement. The standard unit is called the SI unit. Do you know where was this metric system started? This metric system was started in France in the year 1790s. In the year 1790s, the metric system was started in the country France. Now let us start with our chart. Now here you may not understand what is it. You may say, yeah, this is mass, kg, hg, dag, there is some arrow. You won't understand what it is. But first, before covering this thing up, we have to cover this table so that you can understand what is this. Let us start the class. So this is a place value in decimal system. This is prefix that is used for representing the decimal in the metric system. For 1000, we use kilo, and the small form of kilo is K. For 100, we use hecto. Small of hecto is H. For tens, we use deca. And for deca, it is DA. For ones, we cannot say anything specified because that all depends upon the SI unit. The SI unit of mass is gram, SI unit of length is meter, SI unit of volume is liter. So our ones depends upon the SI. Tenths is deci, that is D. Hundredths is centi, that is C. And thousandths is milli, that is M. So now, some people may get confused in two terms, that is deci and deca. Now here, deci means only D, the smaller one, the tenths one, that is deci, that only means D. If we get D plus any SI unit, that is deci. And if we get dA plus any SI unit, that is deca. So this is the difference between the SI and deca unit. Now, let us take the abbreviation kilo, K, hecto, H, etc. with our SI unit, that is gram, meter, liter. Okay. So K, first we have mass. Kg, that is kilogram, Hg, hectogram, decagram, gram, decigram, centigram, milligram. Now let us find out the answer to the question, where do we use the metric system? We use metric system mostly in our day-to-day life. For example, let us take the example of mass in kg. Just we can assume that I am going to a market. I have to buy some rice. How can I find out that how much rice do I buy out? So for this, we have our unit kilogram. Like I should buy 10 kg of rice, I should buy 5 kg of rice, I should buy 2 kg of tomatoes, 5 kilos of potatoes. So this is how we use the term kg. Gram also we can use, that I want to buy 500 grams of pulse, 500 grams of vegetable or something, 500 grams of lemon, 500 grams of chilies, etc. etc. Now where do we use the term milligram? Milligram is mostly related to pharmaceuticals. Milligrams is used You may have heard of some tablets named paracetamol or crocin or something. So these all tablets have some chemicals in them. How do we know that how much chemicals are in that? They will not be directly putting here 1 kilogram of chemicals in one tablet. So for that, they are using the term milligram, that is mg. So we can say that this tablet is 500 mg of tablet, this is 200 mg of tablet, etc. Now let us see where do we use length. Length is used in two terms, for measuring distances in the terms of place and the terms of clothing. Now for example, I am in Chennai, I want to go to Lucknow, the distance approximately will be 3000 km. So here we use the term kilometer. Where do we use meter? A tailor uses a meter rod to check out how much clothes do he need. Meter. Where do we use a millimeter? In a max exam paper, you get a question that draw a circle of a radius 3.5 centimeter. The 3 will be a centimeter and the 0.5 will be a millimeter. In the scale, there are the millimeters unit. So this is where we use the millimeter. Next, we have a volume. What is the volume? A volume means only liquid. What is a liquid? A liquid is like just a state of water or something. So for example, let us take kiloliter. You might have seen in many big factories there are big gallons filled with water, some acid. So they are in kiloliter. Big metro waters, they have 1 kiloliter of water, 5 kiloliters of water. 1 kiloliter is equal to 1000 liters of water. That is not very small amount, that is a very big amount of water. Where do we use liter? We can use liter that this is a water bottle. This water bottle is 1 liter. I drank the 1 liter bottle. This is a 2 liter of Coca-Cola, Pepsi or something. So this is where we use a liter. And we use milliliter. Let us assume that I am having a cough or cold. So if I am having a cold, I have a cough syrup. Where do I use a cough syrup? This cough syrup, they will be saying you can have 5 ml. 5 milliliter per 3 hours. So this 5 milliliter is the unit where we use about the volume. Now let us see the relationship between all those units. Kg to Hd multiplied by 10 into 10. Here divided by 10. Now, let us assume a simple SI unit. I can assume that I am having 1 meter. 1 meter. 1 meter equals to 10 decimeter. 1 meter is equal to 10 decimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 10 decameter. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 100 hectometer. And 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometer. Now let us take the exact opposite of all those things. 1 meter is equal to 10 decimeter, so this 10 decimeter is equal to 1 meter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meter. 1000 millimeter is equal to 1 meter. 1 millimeter is equal to 1 by 1000 meter. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 10 decameter, and 1 decameter consists of 10 meter. 1 hectometer consists of 100, as hecto is 100. And 1 kilo consists of 1000, as kilo is 1000. So this is how we can say that we have a relationship between all those things. Now I have one more topic to say you. I say that these all things like kilo, hecto, deca and gram, everything are in terms of tens. Can you say that I am correct or not? Let us take an example. We can take 1000, that is our kilo, 100 is our hecto, 10 is our deca, 1 is our SI, 0.1 is our deci, 0.01 is our centi, and 0.001 is our मिली. सो किलोग्राम टू मिलीग्राम, किलो टू मिली इज द लार्जर टू स्मॉलर यूनिट, दैट इज अ डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. एंड मिली टू किलो, दैट इज अ स्मॉलर टू लार्जर, दैट इज द असेंडिंग ऑर्डर. नाउ आई कैन से दैट 100, दिस ऑल हैव अ रिलेशनशिप. What is the relationship between all those things? The relationship is the tens. If I multiply 0.001 times 10, we get 0.01. If I multiply this 0.01 times 10, I get 0.1. If I multiply 0.1 times 10, I get 1. If I multiply 1 times 10, I get 10. If I multiply 10 into 10, I get 100. If I multiply 100 into 10, I get 1000. And the same applies here. So this is the vice versa. So if we divide by 10, divide by 100, divide by 10 is 100, 1000 divide by 10 is 100, 100 divide by 10 is 10, 10 divide by 10 is 1, 1 divide by 10 is 0.1, 0.1 divide by 10 is 0.01, 0.01 divide by 10 is 0.001. This is what we got. Hope you understood most of the things about our metric system. In the next video, we'll be learning how to solve some word problems that I have taught everything from part 1 to part 6. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Please like, share and subscribe my video. In the next video, we'll be learning the word problems. See you next time in the next video. Goodbye.